15 October 2020, MRCC Cape Town became aware of the vessel, the geosearcher, that had apparently or reportedly struck a rock and was taking on water. The vessel had 62 crew on board, and all crew managed to abandon vessel into life rafts, and some of their smaller power boats that were busy with fishing managed to tow them around to the weather station situated on Gough. The vessel had struck the rock approximately 1.8 or 0.8 of a nautical mile north of Gough Island. The operation to get them around went off fairly successfully, managed by the crew on board themselves. However, this posed a challenge to the maritime rescue authorities in South Africa, as we had just now learned of 62 additional persons that were placed on the island, which was really only equipped to deal with 10 or 12 people over a season while at the weather station. MRCC, in conjunction with SAMHSA and other government agencies, Department of Environmental Affairs and AMSOL, immediately started making plans to try and get a vessel down to Gough Island to try and recover those people and bring them back to South Africa. We managed to, via discussions and arrangements, get the SA Agulhas II to return to Gough Island and to recover the 62 survivors of the geosearcher. On arrival at Gough Island, the weather on the first day was not very favorable, so operations had to be stalled. But as soon as a weather break appeared, the helicopter was launched, and within a matter of 20-25 minutes, all people were recovered from the island and put onto the SA Agulhas II. Before returning to Cape Town, the SA Agulhas II delivered two of the survivors, who were Tristan citizens, back to the island and then departed for Cape Town. Yesterday, the 26th of October 2020, at about 18:30, the SA Agulhas docked in Cape Town, and proceedings started to process the people back into the country as far as their immigration status and health status were going. It's been one of the most successful, or it's been the most successful operation in at least the past 10 years of the Maritime Rescue Center, and it's with great thanks to all cooperating parties, the Department of Environmental Affairs, AMSOL, Home Affairs, Department of Health, that we could achieve this, the success, and we could get these guys back, these guys and girls back to their families in Cape Town successfully. From the side of the MRCC, we like to just express our gratitude to everybody involved in making this operation as successful as it was.